Let's compress this vocal. So I'm heading over to the browser again. I'm in the audio effects category. Here's the compressor already selected, and I'm gonna just click it and drag it into the audio effects chain down here. So there are three views to this compressor. This one I think is the easiest way to set the threshold. There's an XY axis, which shows you the ratio. It's easy to visualize the ratio. And then here we have a real-time analyzer as well. So let's start over here and get the threshold set. I have highlighted the first part of the chorus. Setting the compressor, it's good to do it in a more dynamic area of the song. Choruses tend to have the times when you're singing the loudest versus the softest. And you can actually see the different peaks and valleys in this file versus the ones over here are just a little bit more even in their tone. So we want to use the compressor to even out this dynamic range more importantly. So as I pull this threshold down while this is playing, you're gonna see gain reduction illustrated here for me as I go. So let's start by just setting the ratio to maybe 4:1, 5:1, just someplace around there. That's a pretty typical ratio for compression of a vocal. It's not too heavy. And I'm gonna press play and pull this down until I'm getting about 5 to 6 dB of gain reduction. Let's also solo it right now so we can hear this happening.
Don't tell me it's not that easy. Too much of a sacrifice.
All right, so you can see that I am reducing gain. I'm gonna take makeup gain off for a second so we can see this even more. So this adjustment of the threshold is really gonna adjust the overall volume. You'll hear that it's gonna be quieter because we're reducing the gain.
Don't tell me it's not that easy. Too much of a sacrifice.
So let's head over to the other view here and you can see this happening.
Don't tell me it's not that easy. Too much of a sacrifice. Don't tell me it's not that easy.
So the difference is when I turn this compressor off, those really high notes, the don't tell me it's not, they're gonna stick out really hard.
Don't tell me it's not that easy. Too much of a sacrifice.
So you can see it's much more even when the compressor's on. It's just taking the volume and lowering it when it crosses the threshold too much. So we might be even be able to notch this down a little bit more. It's a very dynamic file. I always try to not compress too much when I do this, and it's tempting, but let's not. So if I put makeup gain back on, that's gonna adjust this output. So whatever reduction we reduced for these peaks, it's also making the valley softer as well. So the makeup reduction is going to make up for that overall gain reduction and raise the volume of the file back up to where it was generally before.
Don't tell me it's not that easy.
You can see we're actually clipping here anyways. So I'm just gonna reduce this down.
Don't tell me it's not that easy.
Usually you want a compressor to, you want the volume or the overall volume to kind of stay the same because you're not using the compressor to add gain. You're using it to even out the dynamic range. So I like to turn the compressor on and off and just listen to the volume. And if I'm close, then I did a pretty good job of setting the parameters on this compressor.
Don't tell me it's not that easy. Too much of a sacrifice.
So because I'm not hearing a drastic change in volume, I know that my output is set well, and I'm hearing the evenness as well, and we can see it happening here.
Don't tell me it's not that easy. Too much of a sacrifice. Don't tell me it's...
So this is pretty cool. I like watching it. You can see this is the threshold, and you can see the audio crossing the threshold.
Don't tell me it's not that easy.
So only when the file crosses the threshold is it compressing. And then the ratio here, you can see this is how much it's being squashed. It's a little bit difficult to understand in the beginning. But if I turn this ratio all the way up, you can see how much it would be squashed once it crosses the threshold, which is where this dot currently is. And if I pull back all the way, there's no compression. So I'll set this back to about 5 or 6. And that's how you're gonna set the main parameters on the compressor. Just use your ears. The more you do this, the easier it becomes.